Hello and welcome, welcome. We are super excited to have you here. My name is James. I go by Mr. Yogi, and we have Rhea C coming in to help us out with our flow today. And we're from Project Little Warriors, and we have an amazing flow for you today. It's a quick half-hour flow. We're basically going to have a theme of self-discipline. Self-discipline, all right? So we're super excited that you're here to flow with us today. And we are going to begin on our mat in child's pose. So even if you don't have a mat, just go ahead and grab a space on the ground. If you are on the mat, just gently have a seat. Bring your big toes to touch, your knees spread them nice and wide. What you're gonna do is just sit your hips over your heels as you begin to walk your hands out in front of you. Spread your fingers out nice and wide. Now you can make this a very active child's pose by lifting your elbows off the ground, pressing through your hands, shooting energy from your fingertips all the way to your hips. Or you can be more relaxed and just settle in. What I would like for you to do is begin to let go of everything that has happened earlier today, whatever might need to happen later. And I simply want you to ground yourself. Come to this space and this place with an attitude of gratitude. Being aware of our breathing. How does it feel when you go in with the air? How does it feel when you let the air go out as naturally as possible? As you begin to find your grounding, begin to inhale through your nose, lick your lips and seal them, and exhale out of your nose as well. Now, my yogis, this is your beautiful Ujjayi Pranayama breath. This is your warrior breath, your victorious breath. We will use this throughout class to keep heat within our body, the energy flowing from head to toe. Almost see if you can create a sound that sounds like the waves crashing on the ocean. Inhale through your nose, dragging the air across the back of your throat. Exhale out of your nose, again releasing the air out across the back of your throat. One to three more breaths before we begin to find some movement. Again, I invite you to release anything that has happened or any thoughts of what you may need to do when you leave here. Right now, just settle in. One more inhalation fully. Full exhalation, let it all go. On your next inhalation, press through your hands. Come up to a tabletop pose, stacking shoulders over wrists, hips over knees. Bring your gaze right in between your two thumbs, and your gaze will be referred to as your drishti. That's where you're looking. Inhale, drop your belly down. Bring your gaze up. Reach your shoulder blades together. Exhale, cat pose. Round out your back. Tuck through your belly button as it comes to your spine. Inhale, cow pose. Belly down, shoulder blades together. Arch your back. Reach up with your gaze. And then exhale, cat pose. Round out like a scary cat. Push the earth away. Two more on your own. Inhalation gives you a cow pose. Exhalation, you'll find a cat pose. And find a tabletop pose on your next inhalation and just stay there, keep breathing. As you move today, there may be a pose or something that you do not know. Allow your mind to get creative and just to move. What do you think it's supposed to look like? Where do you want to go with it? Let's get creative and work on that theme of self-discipline. No judgment, just you staying strong in your mind and allowing that to show up as it may in your body. Inhale, tuck your toes under, get ready to move. Exhale, downward facing dog. Shoot your hips up and back. Press your back to your chest and your chest to your thighs and just wiggle around here. You'll be here for a few breaths. Sit Settle in. Press through your fingertips a lot here. Activate your hasta bandha. That's simply a hand lock. That means pressing so firmly down that you can rise up, feeling more, being more, and introducing more. Inhale. Exhale, let it go out of your nose. Nice self-discipline. Inhale, look forward to the top of your mat. And exhale, tippy-toe your feet to their behind your hands, ragdoll pose. So just like it sounds, keep your knees bent heavy, nice and wide, and just hang like a ragdoll. Hips are high, torso's on your thighs. Rock back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And when you found all the movement you were searching for, begin to find stillness. Shake your head no for no worries, no excuses. Shake your head yes for self-discipline, self-love, and however it shows up in your life. Inhale, release your hands down to your mat. Exhale, heel toe your feet all the way together. Big toes to touch, nose to sliver, space apart. With your knees bent, inhale, rise up slow as possible, stacking vertebrae on top of vertebrae. Heads hung heavy the whole time. Come all the way to the top. Roll your shoulders generously up and back, down and around. One time, two times, and three times. And then let's go to the front. Down, up, and around. Two times. And after your third time, bring your hands to heart center. Samasthitihi, standing at attention, where we will set our intention for today. We've already alluded to it, and that is simply being and existing with self-discipline. How does that look? Well, sometimes you may have to do something that's not necessarily comfortable. Maybe you'll be in a yoga pose and you want to leave the pose because it's hurting, or at least that's what your body is telling you. I invite you to stay in the pose one more breath. I invite you to stay in the uncomfortable feeling one more full time, whatever that looks like, on or off the mat, in or out of school. Inhale fully with everything you desire. Exhale fully, releasing everything you don't desire. Two more just like that. Inhale fully, love, discipline, awareness. Exhale all the fear that comes along with those things. Last one, best one. Inhale fully, filling up. Bring in more, bring in even more, even more. Open your mouth, exhale, release your hands to your side, flutter your eyes open, welcome to your moving meditation. Inhale, mountain pose, Tadasana, hands reach up high, shoulders reach down low. Plant your feet in the mat by lifting your 10 toes. I'm not scared, I'm just. Breathe here, engage your core, tuck your glutes under. Yes, so good, nice alignment. Living in full expression from the ground up at all times. Inhale, get ready to move. Exhale, easy twist to the right. Open up, bringing your right arm down and behind you. Gaze stays in front, behind you. Nice and strong there, self-discipline. Can you bring that right hip forward a little bit more? Yes, so good, Rhea. Inhale, mountain pose, Tadasana, sweep up high. Exhale, easy twist to the left. Let your gaze follow your hand all the way to the back. Left hip dials forward. Inhale, mountain pose, Tadasana. Exhale, baby back bend, hips forward, elbows at 90 degree angle. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold, dive down as hands move through heart center. When you can't reach any further, release your hands. Inhale, halfway lift, hands meet shins or thighs, shoulders away from your ears. Exhale, high plank, plant your hands below your shoulders, step your feet behind you. Inhale, shift forward to your tippy toes and lower down to a low plank. And then inhale, upward facing dog. Tops of your feet into the mat, shoulders back, gaze forward. Exhale, downward facing dog, hips up high. So good. Two breaths before we move again. Everything we've done, we do one more time. One breath to one movement. Now, if you want to go a little bit slower than my voice or a little bit faster than my cue, feel free to move freely. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step or float, top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, easy twist to the right. Open up slowly but surely. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, easy twist to the left. Work on that core strength. Inhale, mountain pose. Stabilizing the core again. Exhale, baby back. Bend hips forward, chest high. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, high to low plank, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Now know that you can drop to your knees if you need to here. Exhale, downward facing dog. Beautiful. Now let's add on a little bit here, my yogis. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, travel to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Here's the change. Inhale, chair pose, Ugatasana. Sit your butt low as you reach your hands high. So strong. Tuck your belly button in. Yes, so good. Relax your shoulders down your back. So strong in your chest. Inhale, grow tall in your chest. Exhale, sit low in your hips. One more inhale. Exhale, bring your hands to heart center and twist to the right on empty. So chair pose with a prayer twist. Left elbow meets the outside of your right knee and you look up and over that shoulder and notice how she's twisting from her hips. You can still see a small space in between her chest and her core and her thighs. One more inhale. Exhale, look up even more, open up even more. Inhale, look down. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Heel toe your feet, hip width distance apart and bend your knees slightly and exhale, gorilla pose. Bring your feet right on top of your hands. So work your hands under your feet and almost bringing your toes to your wrists so you can give yourself a massage. Chin is tucked into your chest, elongating your spine. You can get more active here by bending at your elbows, pulling your torso even closer to your legs as you straighten through your knees, or you can stay relaxed. You're here for one more breath cycle. In through the nose. Out through the nose. Inhale, lift one hand. Exhale, lift the other hand. Inhale, halfway lift. Heel toe your feet back together. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose. Sit low, sweep high. Exhale, sink deeper. Inhale, self-discipline. Exhale, self-love as you sit deeper and example. Inhale. Exhale, hands come to heart center. And on empty, twist to the left. Same objective here, bringing that elbow on the outside of your knee, keeping your knees aligned with each other. So bring that right knee back just a little bit, engaging your core, mind is strong. That makes your body strong. Inhale. Exhale, twist even more. Inhale, look down. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, crow pose. We're just gonna go for it. Plant your hands directly below your shoulders. Bend your knees, come up on to your tippy toes. Knees meet your triceps, you look forward. You can stay here, lift one foot. Maybe you lift the other foot. Challenge yourself for four. You kick back in three. You're so strong for two. Chaturanga in one. Feet go back. Chaturanga, beautiful. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Let's keep moving, my yogis. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Exhale, bring your foot down. Warrior one. So bring your foot down, plant it in between your hands, and spiral your back foot down 45 degree angles. Bring your hands up. Front knee should be stacked over your ankle, and that back foot is at a 45 degree angle. So good. Press through that knife edge of your left foot. Yes, get more activation in that left leg. Inhale. Exhale, dial your left hip forward a little bit. Yes, feel that twist. Inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Spiral your back foot down parallel with the outside back edge of your mat. Front knee stays bent. And your core is engaged, so your shoulders are over your hips. So strong. Now notice how the arms are in one line. So left arm comes up just a little bit. And we stay nice and strong. Inhale. Exhale, stay. Inhale, prepare to move. Exhale, we stay. Inhale, straighten out your front leg. Shoot your hips back. Exhale, fold forward. Tic-tac your arms to 6 and 12. Hot triangle trikonasana pose. So a micro bend in your right knee, nice adjustment here. Really want to work on not hyperextending that leg, but we want to work on that chest expansion as we bring our shoulder blades together. Inhale. Exhale, open up. One more inhale. One more exhale. Inhale, press through your feet. Keep your legs straight. Reverse triangle. Reach all the way up and back. Exhale, cartwheel your hands down to the mat. High to low plank. Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Good job. Inhale through your nose. Exhale, open your mouth, let it go. Now let's move. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, bring it down through your hands, warrior one. So we bring our hands up as we spiral our back foot down, just at a 45 degree angle. So good. Front knee is over that front ankle. Inhale. Exhale, settle in. Can you dial that left, right hip forward just a little bit? Engage your core. Inhale. Exhale, stay. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, warrior two, open up. So good. Couple breaths here, inhale. Exhale, stay nice and strong. Notice how her shoulders are over her hips. Knee is over the ankle, so good. Inhale, strength for love. Exhale, stay. Inhale, straighten your front leg. Kick your hips to the back. Exhale, reach forward, and we tic-tac our arms, Trikonasana once again. Keep that left or that left leg straight, just a small bend in it. Good, inhale. Exhale, open up. One more inhale. One more exhale. Pressing through your feet, inhale, reverse triangle, reach up and back. Exhale, partway your hands all the way down to the mat, high to low plank, chaturanga, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. All right, three breaths here to reset, yogis. Come back to your intention. Come back to your purpose. We're gonna put all that together, one breath to one movement. And again, if you wanna flow faster than I go, go ahead. If you wanna go a little bit slower, again, go right ahead. You are amazing. When we activate, we can demonstrate self-discipline by showing ourselves self-love, knowing that it may be a little uncomfortable, but we know it's gonna pay off. All right, yogis, inhale, look forward. Exhale, step or jump, top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose. Listen for the subtle change. Exhale, easy twist to the right. Open up. There we go. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, easy twist to the left. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, high to low plank, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Exhale, warrior one, bring it down. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, straighten that leg. Exhale, triangle. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale, cartwheel your hands down. High to low plank, chaturanga, so beautiful. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Let's keep it going. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, warrior one. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle. Oh no, inhale, triangle. Exhale, stay. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale, cartwheel your hands down. High low plank, chaturanga. Stick with your breath. Stay anchored. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. So good. And we're going to do all of that. We're just going to add on a little bit more. Stay with me. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, chair plane. Listen for the change. Inhale, one-legged Tadasana. Right leg rises. Exhale, figure four. Put that right ankle on that left knee. Stay strong. Two full breath cycles. And Inhale, one leg of Tadasana. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, high to low plank, chaturanga. Nice kickback. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Exhale, warrior one. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, star pose, heels in, toes out, hands up. Exhale, wide-legged forward fold, Pasarita. Feet are gonna parallel with the sides of your mat. Bend your knees slightly. Inhale, bring your right hand to your left shin. Exhale, bring your left hand up and twist. Beautiful, stay wherever you are. We're here for one breath. Inhale, left hand slowly comes down to meet the outside of your right shin. Release your right hand. Same thing, opposite side. Yes, beautiful, Rhea. Move intuitively with your body. It knows what to do. Inhale. Exhale, stay. Inhale, we prepare. Exhale, forward fold all the way down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, warrior two to the front. Inhale, reverse warrior. Front knee stays bent. Exhale, caught with your hands. High to low plank. Chaturanga. Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Notice she kept her foot up for option. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step or float, top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, chair plane. Inhale, one leg of Tadasana, left leg lifts. Exhale, figure four, left ankle, right knee. Chest proud. Two breath cycles. Inhale, one-legged Tadasana. Reach up, go up, get up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, high to low plank. Chaturanga, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, warrior one. Bring it down. Inhale, lift. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, star pose. Heels in, toes out, hands up. Exhale, bring your hands behind your back. Interlace your fingers. Inhale, puff out your chest and bring your feet parallel with the sides of the mat. And exhale, wide-legged forward fold. Pasarita. 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 Keeping your hands in a bind until it no longer serves you. Notice how they're raised up above the lower part of your back. Inhale. Exhale, release your hands down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, warrior two to the front. Inhale, reverse warrior. Front knee stays bent. Exhale, high to low plank. Last chaturanga, make it count. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Three breaths before we move. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Before I last. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, ripple forward to a high plank. Bring your feet parallel, shoulders over your wrist. And we lower down slowly for four, three, two, one. All the way down. Bring your hands beside you. No, just beside you, right beside your chest. Setting up for a cobra pose, as we call it. Feet are together. Zipper your legs like a book. Inhale, we press our tops of our feet into our mat as we come up. And our hands are slightly off of our mat. We're looking right in front of our mat, using your core, your posterior, your spine. We're almost there. Release in three, two, one. Bring it down. Bring your hands beside you. Bend your knees. Once you wipe your knees back and forth, left to right, right to left. Great job. All right, keep your knees where they are and come up with your hands to grab outsides of your feet, setting up for floor bow. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, come all the way up. Press through your feet, come up, yes. Here we go. Hold it for three, two, one. Let it go. Let it go, beautiful. Come up to standing on your knees. And just sweep your feet out in front of you. Seated position, feet all the way out in front of you. Inhale as you reach up. Exhale, seated forward fold. Bend your knees slightly here. Just settle in. Inhale.
Exhale, let it go.
Almost there. A little bit of work still to be had. Inhale, come up. All the way. Exhale, slowly lower yourself all the way down. Setting up for figure four. So bring your feet both flat on the ground. Left ankle is gonna meet right knee. And we thread the needle by pressing our hands under your right thigh. Coming up and stretching here. You can press your left elbow into your left knee to get more of a stretch in that hip flexor. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. Exhale, pull your leg as close as you can. One more inhale. One more exhale. Inhale, hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a little bit of love. Exhale, switch it out, opposite side. So bring your right ankle on your left knee. Thread the needle by pressing your hands under that left thigh. Right elbow is going to meet that right knee. Press it out. Inhale. Exhale, press. Inhale. Exhale, let it go. Inhale. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, release. Hold everything in. Hug everything into your chest. Give yourself the biggest sign of love right here. Self-love equals that self-discipline. You made it to the end. Bring everything in that you need right here, right now. And exhale, final Shavasana. Bring your feet below you, your hands beside you. Close your eyes. And know that this space for grace, this attitude of gratitude is always here. Settle in and allow yourself just to forget, just to let go. Self-discipline. Self-discipline equals self-love. You are all you need. Anytime doubt or anything comes in you, remind yourself how strong you are, and that may show up different. Being uncomfortable, being happy, being joyful, they all are different forms of self-discipline. Spiral your ankles and your wrists and stretch your feet below you, your hands above you. Give yourself a good morning stretch like you just woke up. And then roll over to your favorite side in the fetal position. Knowing that this attitude of gratitude, this space for grace is always available. It's simply waiting on you to make the decision, waiting on me to show up. And then once we show up, anything's possible. Slowly come up to an easy seat position, using as much ease and as little effort as possible, crossing your legs. Eyes are closed or very gently open. Bring your hands to heart center. Press your thumbs against your heart against your thumbs. In this moment, we recognize that we have a heart. That means we have a beat, and that means we have a purpose. May you follow it. May you find it. May you love it. Raise your thumbs to your lips, knowing that you have the ability to speak words of influence and power. So we take responsibility for the words we say and how we say them, and more importantly, how people interpret what we say. Speaking words of joy and discipline to ourselves and everyone around us. Raise your thumbs to your eyes, knowing that we must see the opportunity and see that the discipline actually means love. It's not punishment, or it's not anything that takes away. It actually adds value to us. Raise your thumbs to your third eye center, your seat of intuition. This is the space where you know what you know without knowing how you know it. The third layer of your brain. May you forever and always follow this voice. Follow yourself and know that you are enough and you are radiantly beautiful from the soles of your feet to the crown of your head. We bow forward simply to seal our practice and we say namaste. Thank you all so very much for coming and joining with us at Project Little Warriors. Miss Rhea, Mr. Yogi, we're super excited you're able to flow with us today. And I really hope you saw the correlations and the parallels with self-discipline and how it shows up on your mat. And I pray that you will take this off your mat for a better and more enriched life, for better decisions today and tomorrow. We love you guys. Talk to you soon.